Hey, Triangle Bob, you're so tiny! Wait a minute, did you mess with my shrink ray again? Yes, I see now that you totally did, judging by the looks of this room. Hey, animator, any chance we could resize Triangle Bob? Animator? Huh. That's weird. Well, good news though, Itty Bitty Bob here has me thinking of a fun video idea. What's the smallest size humans have ever been? And how would it impact our world if humans were smaller now? Let's find out. Time to go on a journey through the land of human heights. Hey there, welcome to Life Noggin. First station, Neanderthals. These stubby folks stood about 5 feet 5 inches tall and roamed around from 400,000 to 40,000 years ago. Then we've got Homo floresiensis, at just 3 feet 6 inches tall. When it comes to modern folks, the pygmies of Central Africa stand at around 4 feet 11 inches. Compare that to the European guys 10,000 years ago who averaged 4 feet 4 inches, a good 5 inches shorter than today, much taller than our itty bitty Bob here. The average height for a little person or person of short stature is 4 feet, while the shortest person ever recorded was a Nepalese man named Chandra, measuring 1 foot 9.5 inches. An Iranian man named Afshin is the shortest person alive today, standing at 2 feet 2 inches tall. What explains some of these heights? Well, food on one hand. Poor nutrition can stunt growth by limiting energy and protein necessary for cell development and by causing deficiencies in essential micronutrients required for various growth functions. But another reason for some of these smaller heights are short stature disorders. They're usually caused by genetic or hormonal factors that alter a person's development and bone growth. Achondroplasia is one of the most common forms of a short stature disorder, accounting for 70% of cases. This genetic mutation affects the growth of cartilage in the bones of a person's arms and legs, resulting in a larger head in proportion to the rest of the body and shorter limbs. So, how would life look if humans were smaller now? Well, the average human is 5'6 for a male and 5'2 for a female. Everyone being just a little smaller might have some impact. Currently, you humans need about 25 to 30 calories per kilogram of body weight to maintain your weight. But if human bodies were smaller and needed less food to fuel their diminutive daily activities, it would mean less food production is needed, and that would lead to fewer carbon emissions. The present food system is responsible for approximately 26% of worldwide greenhouse emissions, encompassing various stages like agriculture, packaging, and transportation. Reducing the size of individuals might also result in decreased emissions, particularly in transport, which currently accounts for a significant 16% of total emissions. Car manufacturers have already started producing lighter vehicles to enhance fuel efficiency and lower emissions, so applying the same principle to humans could yield similar benefits. But to all my short kings out there, you're beautiful just the way you are. Itty Bitty Bob, you are beautiful the way you are right now, but you want to probably go back to how you were. After a few adjustments on my patent-pending resizerator, it's time to fix Triangle Bob. And he's back. Sort of. I'll just keep firing until he looks a bit better, okay? Oh, after running some polls, it seemed like our audience really wants us to focus on science videos about movies and games. So, let me know in the comments below right now, what is your favorite all-time game and favorite all-time movie? Do you think that it would make for a fun Life Noggin video? Let's see the Life Noggin audience's taste, shall we? Do all the things that help this channel grow, we really appreciate all the support. Click here to watch this video we did on aging backwards, or click here to watch this video. For more longevity science, check out lifespan.io. They're the team that powers Life Noggin, find them down in the description. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.